Everything. Everywhere. All at once. That's how we want to start our video about our new batch photo processing tool, Arams. This tool allows you to process dozens, hundreds, or even thousands of photos in just a few clicks, freeing up your valuable time for more enjoyable activities, like a cup of coffee. Hello everyone, you're on the Retouch For Me channel. I'm Dennis, and today I'll be your guide into the world of AI processing. Everything. Arams includes everything you need for photo processing. Over 10 plugins help you solve any task, whether it's skin issues, glare, tone adjustments, or even yellow teeth. Simply activate the plugin from the right menu. Everywhere. Arams can be applied to any type of photo. Moreover, it helps you assign ratings, cull unsuccessful shots, and highlight the best from your collection. All at once, Arams allows you to apply multiple effects and plugins simultaneously. Click Export, wait for the process to complete, and your photos will be ready to publish. Now let's move on to practice. Go to the Arams page on the Retouch For Me website and click Get Arams. Log into the site and choose the platform you are going to work on. After downloading, install the program and launch it. Now log in by clicking the Login button in the top right corner and entering the credentials you used on the website. Arams will then search for the installed plugins. Let's explore the settings section. To do this, click the button in the top right corner. Let's enable automatic face search. This feature is free and designed for quickly comparing faces in photos, as well as automatic photo analysis. This feature is only available with a paid subscription, and it is responsible for analyzing photos using AI for subsequent sorting and rating. To view the list of plugins, switch the tab on the left. Here you will see a list of available plugins, their version, a link to download them, and their activation status. After making sure all necessary plugins are installed and activated, return to the main screen. Click Create a Project and specify the path to the folder with your photos. The project is created. Your photos are loaded and displayed as a grid. Excellent! If you want to add more photos, the Add Photos button in the left corner is for you. Now let's quickly go through the interface, which is visually divided into three parts. The left menu is responsible for sorting, grouping, and displaying photos in the workspace. Sort by. Use this list to sort photos by date, name, rating, or features. Grouping. This tab allows you to group photos by their similarity or processing stage. Filter by. This filters by date created, the range of photo creation dates, rating, the photo rating determined by the algorithm. To check the progress of photo analysis, click on the bell icon in the top right corner. Image features and face features. This is photo characteristics. Full-length person, portrait, or other details like background or lighting. Culling. This sorts by rejected or favorite photos. Folders. This sorts by subfolders in the project directory. Below is a slider for the photo grid size in the workspace. The center showcases your photos, where you have the option to manually reject or add selected shots to your favorites. To see detailed information about a photo, click on it and switch the toggle in the top right corner to Details. There, you will find location data, creation date, personal rating, face features, overall AI assessment, and EXIF information. Switch the toggle back to Export and familiarize yourself with the right menu. Here, you can enable or disable plugins that are already installed on your computer. Clicking on a specific plugin will show its properties, and you can change them if you needed. Then, a list of plugins available for download from the Retouch For Me website. At the bottom, there is a button labeled Export with Correction. When you click on it, you will see Photos to Export. Here you select the category of photos you want to process. Selected, Favorites, or Rejects. Below that is Export To. Choose the path to save the processed photos. If you want the processed photos to be in a separate folder, select Put into Subfolder. If you want to add the processed photos to the project for comparison, check the box Add to Current Project. To add a prefix or suffix to the names of the processed photos, enter it in Naming and Overwriting. I just need to choose the photos I want to edit. Select the plugins for processing and click Export. That's it. The process is started. Now let's check the results. Incredible quality with preserved details. And all this in just a few clicks. How much time would you have spent on each shot? Try this tool for your photo shoot and share the results in the comments. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like this video and click the bell to not miss future videos. See you soon!